Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the preparation of the operating budget. We'll start off with a brief discussion of the purpose of budgeting and the role the operating budget plays within an organization. Next, we'll dive into the key elements of the operating budget and how it's prepared. Understanding how to build and utilize operating budgets can significantly help organizations plan and control the costs within the business. So let's dive in. Manufacturing companies that produce their own products from scratch have numerous decisions to make regarding production, such as how much to produce and understanding what their operating costs will be at a particular level of activity. Have you ever wondered how they determine specifically how many units they're planning to sell and produce each period? Once that's figured out, how do they go about deciding how much raw materials inventory to purchase and how much labor to employ? These are all complicated questions that can make or break a company. Operating budgets play an important role in planning and controlling costs. Operating budgets not only allow the organization to plan for the future, but also allow them to set goals and track the company's performance. Regardless of the size of the business, operating budgets can provide a significant benefit to the organization. Budgets are financial plans that help companies determine the required actions necessary to meet their goals. These goals can be communicated throughout the organization to ensure all departments and employees are working together in alignment. Budgets also allow companies to plan for the future and monitor performance by comparing actual results to their original expectations and taking corrective action. Companies typically create what's called a master budget, which is the overall financial plan for the organization, and usually covers a one-year time frame. The master budget can be broken down further into two key areas: operating budgets and financial budgets. In this video, we're going to focus on the operating budgets, which result in the creation of a budgeted income statement, broken down into multiple smaller budgets that account for the income-generating activities of the business. In a manufacturing company, this would typically include a sales budget, production budget, and individual budgets for manufacturing costs such as direct materials, direct labor, overhead, as well as a budget for administrative costs. The sales budget is usually the first budget prepared and serves as the basis for all the other operating budgets. The marketing and sales departments will work to develop a sales forecast, taking into account the company's past performance, economic conditions, and the organization's expected growth. The forecast will project the number of units the company is planning to sell in the upcoming year and can be broken down by quarter or month. This information will be used to calculate the budgeted sales dollars for each period using the formula expected units times unit selling price would equal our budgeted sales dollars. Let's look at a brief example. Here, XYZ Bike Company is planning to sell 1,000 bicycles in the first quarter of the upcoming year. And as a result of growth, they're planning to sell an additional 1,000 units each quarter after that. As we can see, this works out to 10,000 bicycles for the year. The number of bicycles is then multiplied by the expected selling price of $250 per bicycle, which results in the total budgeted sales or revenue for each quarter totaling $2.5 million for the year. The company now knows how many units they're planning to sell each quarter and the expected revenue they plan to generate. Now, it's a common misconception that once the budget is approved, it's set in stone and doesn't change. While this is true of the original master budget, which is also sometimes called a static budget, companies have the ability to make adjustments to the budget once the year is underway. These adjustments are typically made to account for changes that have taken place in the business or economy following the completion of the budget. Regardless of whether a static or flexible budget is used, since operating budgets include so many inputs, it's a common mistake for certain costs to be missed during the preparation process. This can result in significant errors that flow through to other related budgets and can result in major operational issues if not addressed by the business. As a result, it's important to ensure that all expenses are included during this phase. Back to the example from earlier. Once the company creates their sales budget, it's now time to determine how many units they need to produce each quarter to meet the expected sales demand. This is called the production budget. In quarter one, if there were no bikes in beginning inventory, the bikes to be produced would equal the 1,000 bikes to be sold. However, generally, companies already have some beginning inventory from the last quarter and also might require additional bikes to be made on top of that 1,000 so that they have a buffer zone of inventory available. The formula to calculate the number of units to produce is expected unit sales plus units in desired ending inventory minus units in beginning inventory. Let's say the company started off with 150 units in their opening inventory when the year started, and were required to have another 250 units in ending inventory at the end of quarter one. The production budget for quarter one would be as follows. We'd start with 1,000 units that we're planning to sell, which came straight from the sales budget. Next, we would add in that extra 250 units that the company requires to have on hand at the end of the quarter as a buffer zone. That would give us 1,250 total bicycles that would be required to be produced. However, as I mentioned, the company already had 150 of these units made in their opening inventory. So we can subtract these out, leaving us with a total requirement to produce 1,100 units in that month. This means that even though the company is planning to sell 1,000 units that quarter, they would be asking their production department to produce 1,100 bicycles over that period of time. Now that the manufacturer knows how many units they're planning to produce that quarter, they can move on to producing the direct materials budget, direct labor's budget, and overhead budget. The direct materials budget will give them an indication of both the volume and the cost of raw materials that they need to plan to purchase to support the production in quarter one. It's calculated as follows. The purchases equals the direct materials needed for production, plus the direct materials in desired ending inventory, minus the direct materials in beginning inventory. Next, the company will produce the direct labor budget in order to determine the volume of labor hours and cost of labor required to meet that 1,100 unit production level. This will be calculated as follows. Direct labor cost equals the number of units to be produced times the direct labor hours per unit, multiplied by the average wage per hour. The final manufacturing budget to be produced is called the overhead budget, which forecasts the variable and fixed overhead costs for the year, such as depreciation, rent, and utilities. This will allow the company to calculate the total budgeted production costs for the year. Once these budgets are all produced, the company will now be able to produce a selling and administrative expense budget to factor in all of the non-production costs that they plan to incur throughout the year, such as office costs and salaries for HR, accounting, and marketing departments. Once all of these individual operating budgets are complete and approved, the company can pull this all together into a full budgeted income statement as the finished product. And that brings us to the end of the video. Remember, in order for organizations to be successful in the long run, they need an effective way to develop and communicate goals across the organization and subsequently monitor the company's performance as they strive to meet those goals. Operating budgets are an extremely useful tool that give companies the ability to do this. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.